Okay, so we're going to start again. Good evening, everyone. And thank you very much for all of you participating in this such a great mitzvah. It's not first year, but a couple of years I'm doing that. The reason I'm doing this shiur and day of the birthday, it's a Chabad. It's a Chabad minhag. And Rebbe Milbavich, he used to say it's a very important thing to do that. You know, while we in exile, we're learning a lot of things from the Goyim, from the different nations. And day birthday, whatever do, it's totally nonsense. Because anything you do, you have to know, connect yourself with Hashem Yitbarach and the Torah and whatever the Torah teaches us. So the important thing is that every single person here, every single Jew, while he want to do birthday, it's important too the way we doing, the way I doing right now. It's also a lesson to everyone to learn to do that. It's not just go to a restaurant, you know, with my father or my brother or my friend's birthday, let's go to a restaurant, sit everybody and eat and say happy birthday, all the best, and sit and drink, and that's it. One of the point, if you're going to do that with washing your hands and say, Anshadam, Wuzilacham in Ardi, Birkat Amazon, it's also good. But when you with the Shi'ur, specifically doing your lesson and learning Torah, that's highest level and it's the important way to do it. So what I picked today? I picked today about the house. And I want everybody here, it's very, very important, and to learn and to know in their life, what is this house, first thing? What is this house about? How we have to succeed to have a house? And when you have a house, what are you supposed to do? And when you're in exile, could you have a house also or not? And the difference between house in Israel and outside from Israel, and Beit HaMikdash, a third temple, Bezat Hashem, which would be Ibaneh, Aliyad Me'ashach Tzidkeinu, that called also a house. All of them call house. But the Beit HaMikdash, the temple, it's a house of Hashem Yitbarach. That's the highest house. And all of us basically learn and pray and keep mitzvot for that house. And not only that, your house, listen to this, guys, your house connected with the house of Hashem. Do you believe it? Your house connected with the house of Hashem, with the temple, with the Beit HaMikdash. The question is, if you connect that house, which means your house, the question is, if you know how to connect your house with the house of the Beit HaMikdash. It's not for no reason. The Chazal said in the Gemara, all the houses of the Jewish people, with the house Torah and Mitzvot and the right direction of their life, they go with the house to Israel. Sometimes people think it's a fantasy. How is possible, you know? It's not fantasy. And it's a possibility. So I explain, not everything. I was reading in Parashat Tazria about the... we learned, I think, last week, I think, or 2 weeks ago, about Tazria Metzora. It's not about the leprosy, and the Tum'ah, and the blemish in the house, and all other stuff, what it's supposed to do. And it was in Israel. And when the Jews came to Israel, and the reason for this, and for what? So I was reading in Mr. Tazria, I was seeing that, and it was very interesting to me that he brings so many explanations which I cannot say everything, but I can say some of them. Let's start like this. What is this house? How I have to buy a house? How I have to buy a house? How, what I should do it to have a house? Or when I buying a house, what I supposed to do? We call that the one of the minhagim was minhag kodesh, a holy minhag, Chanukat Habayit. Everybody knows. Chanukat Habayit. That we're sitting, you buy a house, You bring 10 people. We say all the whatever sages write it down to us to pray. We say Kaddish, we bless the person, and that's called Hanukkah Tabayit. Now, some people do even, you are renting a house, not only you're buying a house, also doing Hanukkah Tabayit. So the question is, it's good or it's not good? I mean, or you don't need to, or it's not necessary? It's also a question. And what's happening when the person doesn't do Hanukkah Tabayit? Or before Hanukkah Tabayit, if there is any other details, what you're supposed to do before you buy the house? So things go like that. First of all, it's a pasuk like this. Bochokhma yivne bayit. Nachon? Bochokhma yivne bayit. In a chokhma, in a wisdom, you build a house. So you have to ask question. I could ask question like this. Why did he say bechesed yivne bayit? Right, there's a pasuk, by the way. Hashem said bechesed yibane haolam. In the merciness, olam b'chesed yibane. Yeah, olam b'chesed yibane. It's the purpose. It's said. Hashem said in the pasuk that Hashem created the world in the chesed, but in here, in with the house we're supposed to buy, we're saying b'chokhma yibane bay. In a wisdom, you have to buy a house. Why you have the house? For the house, you're saying b'chokhma. Why not saying b'chesed? I think b'chesed is better, no? What do you think, guys? Now, if you say b'chesed, chesed is a big thing. Chesed? It's a very one of the important things in the life. Without the chesed, it's almost a problem. We need a lot of chesedim. We need a lot of mercy. We need a lot of power of the chesed. How do you say chesed in English? Energy to sharing, kindness.
There's no real translation.
There's no real translation. I knew it. It's really, you know, I'm telling you the truth. One of the reasons I always scream to everybody saying, guys, learn Hebrew. Because when you go to the Hebrew, when you learn Hebrew,
some words you can translate.
Not only that. Let's say you know Hebrew, yeah? Let's say. You know what's chesed. You will understand. Hashem is going to give you the understand what chesed is about. But when you come to translate, you cannot translate. You're not find the word. But when you doesn't know Hebrew, you don't learn Hebrew, you never gonna understand. They're gonna give you kindness, this one sharing, and it's hard. So that's the reason it's important you should learn Hebrew, because it's by the way, the Hebrew, it's your soul language. This is your real soul language, not other languages. That other languages will also us to women. We have to know English, we live here, you know, but don't forget, Hebrew don't live it, take it, don't be lazy, it's important. Now, so it didn't say chesed, or he said b'chokhma yivne bayit. Now listen over here, guys. Rabbi Dalevi Ashlag, Zecher Zecher Sholecha Achar Abba, he said it, he mentioned it many, many times, most all important is Kabbalistically explaining the life is about, is like this. Our job, basically. And this is whatever we do, it's also to your Olam Haba in order to come, which means in your life, the soul, the world of the soul, when you're going, your soul going to live in the world to come. What is that? Our job is like this. First of all, I want to tell you this. Look, listen over here. Any moment you breathe, you're alive, is from the light of Chokhmah, not Chesed, it's from the Chokhmah, the light of Chokhmah, which is giving you a life. Chesed, you also have. What you're supposed to do is, Lalbish or Chokhmah b'chasadim. You have to cover the light of the energy of wisdom to the chesed, to the kindness, how you call that, or whatever he's saying, there's no word, you have to understand the meaning of the chesed. When you cover the ora chokhmah in the chasadim, you could have a long life, you could enjoy the life of the chokhmah, you could have any other good things when you want to receive in your life. Only when you are covered the Ora Chokma with the Chasadim. When you don't do that, you're receiving Ora Chokma with the pain, with the anguish, with the problems, with the negativity, with the chaos. Because there is a chaos in the world too. You see people with the pain. That's called no chasadim enough. There is a Ora Chokma, the light of wisdom, lo mitlabesh, it doesn't covering the chasadim. Lo Ora Chokma, lo mitlabesh b'chasadim. Then it's a problem. Now, when I buy a house, if I don't say that I'm buying a house for Hashem Yitbarach, if I don't say it, that I buy a house for Hashem Yitbarach, to worship Hashem, I'm not creating Ora Chasadim. It's just my mind wanting what? I want. By the way, desire to receive, desire to receive. I want to receive. I want to have. That's called also Ora Chokhmah. That's also wisdom of Chokhmah. It's a wisdom of the, or a light of the Chokhmah. When you have a desire to receive, you have to right away create it also Ora Chasadim. Then you could enjoy that Ora Chokhmah. Without that, you have a problem. So what's happening? So the Zohar said like this, when the Jews come out from Mitzrayim, from Egypt, and being in a Midbar, and they were supposed to go to Israel, yes, there is one of the reasons they said Hashem began purposely to put the blemish and the energy of the Tum'ah on non-clean system in the house of the Kana'anim, that this way they're going to break the house, and they're going to find all the treasury and all other stuff. But not only for that. The Zohar explained. Not only for that, he said, whatever they did, they used to do their house for Avodah Zarah. They not used to buy a house. The nations, in the time of Jews come to the from the Mitzrayim, even in the Mitzrayim, all over the world where they was, anything they used to build, anything they used to do, anything, they used to, everything for idol worshippers, not for the other's sake, just for the Avodah Zarah. Look at the history. This one believe this. This one believe and that. Everything for the Avodah Zarah was. Every single thing. Everything. So basically they used to do everything. Draw. Goyim also receive Ordo Chokhmah, by the way. You know that. Because if there's not going to Ordo Chokhmah, how are they going to live? They're going to die. The Ordo Chokhmah is giving life to all entire universe. Without the Ordo Chokhmah, there's no continue. Cannot go. They not used to do this with the Ora Chasadim. Just with the Chokhmah, with drawing with the Tum'ah, with the unclean system energy. So that created them, that they're supposed to bring a destruction. They brought, basically, destruction for themselves. So this is the Jewish Am Yisrael should go to the Eretz Canaan, and they see the blemish in the wall, the Tum'ah over there, and the Kohen come. It is supposed to break the house, it's to break and bring new bricks and everything, new other stuffs, and build from the beginning. This way they break the Tum'ah and bring in the Kedusha. Now, we, like Jewish people, by right now in the Galut, in this time exile, I mean, we don't have right now Beit HaMikdash, it doesn't have a Kohen, other stuffs. What are we supposed to do? So the thing goes like this. When you have buy a house, you have to know. First thing, you have to connect to Kadosh Baruch Hu. When you connect to Kadosh Baruch Hu, you connect to the third temple. Automatically, your house connected to Beit HaMikdash Shlishi. Could you believe it? You hear what I'm telling you guys? Automatically. But again, when you saying, I'm buying this for sake of Hashem. Not just I'm buying. You know what? I want to do real estate. I want to be a millionaire. That's not called Beit HaMikdash Shlishi. That's business. When you want to do that, but parnasa for Avodat Hashem, and then when you buy a house for yourself, also for Avodat Hashem, that's a different story. So first thing, when you buy a house, you have to connect to Kadosh Baruch Hu. You have to connect. Right away, you're connecting. You know, today, I will also tell one thing, very important, you should know that. We say Sfirat HaOmer, nachon? You say Sfirat HaOmer today. Everybody Sfirat HaOmer said. I said to you, remember, in Sfirat HaOmer, that basically Sfirat HaOmer, basically we're giving power to the Mashiach and Sfirat HaOmer. It's not like just counting, that's it. Okay? And we give power to Mashiach Tzidkenu, and also for the third temple, and also that we're giving power to Mashiach to conquer the entire universe. So what's happening when you're saying, for example, we say today, we said four days and 3 weeks and 3 days. And then after the bracha, we're saying, Arachman, we yachzer avda b'edemesh, v'ilkoveinu, amen. What's happening when you're saying Arachman? When you say Arachman, yeah, the Zohar HaKadosh said, you're bringing the inner light for the Beit HaMikdash. So basically, when you say bracha, you bringing surrounding light. Baruch Ata Hashem, Elokeinu Melech HaOlam, Vashikidisham Tzvano, Asfar Domer. You're creating a surrounding light. You're creating a surrounding light. Listen, I'm telling you, not for yourself, for the Beit HaMikdash Hashlishi. Do you listen what I'm telling you guys? You're saying this bracha, you're creating a surrounding light for Beit HaMikdash Hashlishi. But it's not complete yet. Not complete yet. Then after the bracha, you're saying, Arachman, we have of that better amen. You're bringing an inner light. But inner light, not a lot you're bringing, very little. By the way, when the husband and wife, they get married, when the couple, they get married, it's so incredible, guys. I hope you understand what I'm saying to you. When the husband and wife, they're getting married, yeah? When they sleep together, basically, husband, a father, bringing to the child an inner light. No, not in light, surrounding light. Surrounding light. And the wife, giving to the child an inner light. You understand that? And surrounding light is endless. There's no end for it. It's or makif. But the inner light, it's in the body. How much body, that's how much is holding the light. That because of that, the mind, the brain of the husband, of the man, time of intercourse, it's much important than the mind of the wife. Why? Because he bringing inner light, outer light. He bringing outside light. She's giving inner light. Now what's happening? If she give good thoughts, that inner light, with the lifetime, he leaves. Inner light never stay inside. With the life, it leaves. It's getting fixed, it leaves. Then outside light go inside. So with the father giving you good thoughts, time of intercourse, so he giving outside light to the son or the girl, yeah? By the time, that light, which is endless, it's endless. So, in the end, even the child, let's say wife had an evil thought, so that light didn't leave. So, outside light, that by the time go inside the child, and in the end, he's gonna be a good boy. Then, in the end, he's gonna be choder b'tshuva, and then he's gonna go to the right direction. But if Chas v'Shalom, father had an evil thought, so that in the light, gonna bring chas v'Shalom chaos. He cannot be good boy. Do you see how it's important? The Jewish Am Israel, the couple when they keeping Torah mitzvot, how important is how we do, which kind of things we do when we are connecting with the Torah by being with the husband. But being with the wife. At the house, at the business, and everything. Now, out at home, where you buy a house, if you did it already, Leshem Shamayim, Sek of Hashem, you're already creating in your house, you're already creating outside light. It's a good thought, not bad. When you're doing Hanukkah Tabai, and you're doing all the mitzvot, and continuously, you are creating an inner light. And there is a good harmony at the house all the time. Now, what's happening? Sometimes people telling me I have a fear at the house. It's happened, these things? Happen. Yeah. Some people, yes. Huh?
Fear.
Fear. Fear. Fear.
Ghosts.
Stuff, things. Not to make jokes, guys. What's happening? Why it's happening? The Zohar HaKadosh said, it's because the Hanukkah Tabai or the person by buying the house was not 100% in the right way to do it. I mean, he did it, but not 100% complete. Or they have at the house machloket, too much argument, too much misunderstandings, which creating also a problem to the house. So basically, Jewish person, his life is such important that anything, any movement we do is does a lot. Now listen, another thing, which is an interesting thing. So we said in Tel Beit HaMikdash, when the Jews used to be in the Eretz Canaan, Israel, so they have a blemish at the house, they call the Kohen. They call to the Kohen. And Kohen come and have to see it. What Zohar said over here? You know what he said? He said like this. Tum'ah, it's an unclean system. Right? Tum'ah, it's a negative energy. Right? Negative energy. What is Nega? What's the blemish? Well, which side is this? Tuma or Kedusha? Ah, Rabbi Shalom. Nega, the blemish. Is it from Tuma side or Kedusha side?
It's Din Kasheh.
Huh?
It's Din Kasheh.
Now you're already going to the right answer, whatever they say, but
Tuma.
But what is this? Tuma or Kedusha?
It's Din Kasheh. It's Kedusha.
Huh?
It's not Tuma, it's Din Kasheh.
But again, it has to be Tuma.
It's not Tuma.
That's what is it? So Kedusha.
It's not Kedusha, it's yet. Deen is also Kedusha, but it's Kasheh. The Tum'ah just envelopes it because it's so much Ora Chochmah with Adah Chasadim, so the Tum'ah right away finds a place that it's stuck to it.
No, basically he's saying, you close to it, he's saying basically that the Tum'ah, when the Kohen comes, Kohen, it's Ora Chasadim. Kohen, it's a Chesed. It's energy of positive energy. Kohen, positive energy. That's the God created them. Well, Kohen is Ora Chasadim. When you come to see the house, the blemish, when they're saying I have a blemish at the house, coming fight between blemish and Tum'ah. Unbelievable. They fight. The two energies
are negating each other.
They're getting fight. Guys, you hear what I'm telling to you? Look at our Torah. Look, and then many people saying, Maze, this one. You're gonna start to learn inside. You're gonna get amazed. What is the Torah? It's not a joke. It's a real tough. It's not what is it? It's not that simple thing. So Nega, the blemish, and the Tum'ah, and negative energy, they're getting fight. They fight together. Since they fight together, the Kohen have a power to knock out down both of them in a month and to yeah, he basically moves them from the house. He has power to do that. It doesn't matter how. Even those you're gonna say break the house, it's a tum'ah, or break new bricks, it's a tum'ah, we have to change it. Without that, you cannot give purity to the house. Without that, you cannot give purity. Because of that, look how it's connected. Another connection because of that. Mikveh, it's unbelievable thing. Mikveh, gonna give you the highest evolution in your life. Because the water of mikveh also chesed. The water is also considered a chesed. And also mikveh, if you see the letters, kuf, vav, and mem, and hey, it's also a letter koma. Mikveh, koma, and the same letter. The same with Yod, 151. So how come mikveh is a koma? If you know how to connect in the mikveh, you could reach highest level of koma eluna at other level. You have an evolution.
What's the koma? The level, aliyah.
Yeah.
It's basically...
The translation
is
the
floor. Level up. Level up, yeah.
Good one.
It's like
Mary Brothers.
Yeah.
But again, you have to know how to make the connection. Okay, let's not get stuck with the right. Now, so what's happening? So coming Kohen and see the blemish, the way Rabbi Shalom said, it's a din kasher. Din, it's a strong judgment, but the din is not going to come impaired by himself unless that din, that judgment, come from the tum'ah. He didn't came from the kedusha. He came because of the tum'ah. And that tum'ah, that unclean system energy, came from where? From that person. When he draw that energy of Ora Chokhmah, a lot of wisdom, not for Avodat Hashem. Not for Avodat Hashem. But for his own sake. For himself. Then that blemish appear. You get what I'm talking to you? Then that blemish appear. But when he will draw that Chokhmah, that wisdom, if he draw, not only sake of his enjoyment, but for Hashem, that blemish will not appear. That nagel will not come. But Hashem purposely did this. Because there's two reasons. One of the reasons he did this, because the Zohar was said, the treasury the Jewish people received, it was not only in Mitzrayim when they took all the treasury, whatever you said, they took also all the treasure of the Eretz Canaan. Because they used to take the treasure and hide at the house next to the idols. The idol, it was their god. And they took the treasure and hide it inside the idol. It's my god. He's saying it's God, Rahman al-Islam. So he was hiding it. So Hashem did it purposely. That to not create a blemish when the Jews come, when the Kohen coming and they saying the Tumah and Tahara with the blemish and they breaking the house. To make tahor, to clean the system, to clean, to let the air, to pure the house, and they're receiving over there another treasure, whatever they were supposed to receive, and whatever was deserved to receive, that treasure was supposed to receive in that time. So was that the power of the house? Now, what the difference between house of the Israel and the house in the outside Israel? We know the sages said not one time, many times. The highest level by the house is in Israel, not it's outside from Israel. But let's say we do have a house and people does buy have the house. So it's possible or what we're supposed to do. He said over there, the Zohar Kadosh and other, also the Hasidutish explain us that it's no problem. It's no problem to buy, but with the reason, with the condition that you're saying for Avodat Hashem. So when you do this Avodat Hashem, you have to have a more responsibility, and having a house in the United States, and outside of Israel, for Avodat Hashem, for what, for? And another thing.
Third
Beit HaMikdash. And for the third Beit HaMikdash. Then, if my, and when I'm in my house, doing Shmirat Shabbat, doing in the holy way, outside light, and inner light, and the tefillah, and praying, and doing Shmirat Shabbat, keeping Shabbat, saying Birkat Hamazon, or sometimes you even pray over there. Sometimes happen, you have to pray, and though you have to pray in the minyan, that sometimes you happen, you're praying at the house, or let's say you want to pray in Netz, and you don't have any surrounding you in a shul, so you pray in a Netz, or you want to be up all night. Let's say something happened, coming to your mind. I want to be up all night. I want to be up all night. Not watching TV, Hashem Yishmor. Not playing in the computer. Not doing shtiyot. But learning Torah all night. Until coming next. And you know what he's doing basically? You're creating your house, Beit HaMikdash Shlishi, a third temple.
Also, if a person has a house, he has to have a small piece that is damaged to remind him of the Beit HaMikdash.
Okay, this is already.
I have a leaky roof.
This is already a detail of other stuff. Not only this, many other details. You do Chanukah Dabai.
You make inside my house, I have that.
Yeah, you have that.
Have what?
Right leaky across roof? The door, you walk inside, and you see there's a whole spot over there without any paint.
Right. No, it's not necessary to break something.
No,
it's a little piece aside, not painting, a little bit like that, or other things.
I'm just saying the house and the connection to you.
Yeah, 100%. Yeah, it's one of the halachot that they have. Like said, you have to do this siman for the korban bet hamikdash, and not only that, How about who doing kutikum chatzot and his house? That's the real thing. It's the highest thing. Why? What are you, you're not doing outside. You're doing at your house tikkun chatzot. You're sitting on the floor. You're crying for third temple. What do you do basically? What do? You are preparing for the Beit HaMikdash Lishi. Where do you do this? Well, in your own house. You do this in your own house. So your house getting participate connected to the third temple. You get what I'm saying to you or not? You understand what I'm saying to you? So that's the whole job of the buying a house. The buying a house, it should not be in our mind by thinking only of our own benefit or just the enjoyment. Then it could create the chaos and all other problems. Now, another thing I want to say. Now, how does that Or Chesed, the Hadar Or Chesed, with Or HaChokhmah getting together? We bring the example, we said that when you draw, you have to seek of Hashem, and then you're creating Or HaChasadim, and the light of the HaChokhmah covering the Or HaChasadim, and getting together. But what column does that?
Huh?
So I'm asking, you have to say. Central column does that. And what is central column?
Torah.
Tiferet and the Torah. And you yourself also. How? Does person can be central column?
Yes. That's the whole idea. Aren't you supposed to be the principle?
Okay, but you could be sometimes not central column, you know.
Of course. Yeah. Too much Torah.
But the person himself, I'm saying. You realize what's happening? You yourself, not central column. You have to choose that central column. You have to choose that. You understand what I'm saying? You're not getting.
You have to work on to be in
a Rachamim, Rachamim thinking, looking at me, he's saying,
He's looking at you.
Huh?
He's looking at you.
I know. But you getting it? I don't say Rachamim. The person, by the way, it's unbelievable. It's very scary.
Basically, you're not born lucky. You got to make yourself lucky.
Exactly. Now, I want to tell something. It's very scary. Listen over here, guys. I was sitting one place and I said, the religious guy, so, I don't know, call that weird or unbelievable and something unusual. I said to him, are you know about the law that called resurrection of dead people? He looked at me like, talking about, he doesn't know anything even, religious person. I said, do you know about the resurrection of the poor people? Dead people gonna come out? Look at me, dead people gonna come out? Who said that? I said to him, it's 13 principles of Torah. If you don't believe it, you're not Jewish. Look at me, what? what is it? Say, yeah. I said, yes. If you don't believe in resurrection, if you believe in Chatam Mitim, you're not Jewish. You're not Jewish. Guys, do you know what's happening? You could put tefillin, you could pray, you're not in a central column. Mommy, Hashem Rachem, Hashem Rachem, Rahman Al Islam. Could you put in tefillin in that in such a column? Yeah, it's possible. It's scary. And he said, Rabbi Ashlag, he said, those people, Rahman Islam, Lo Alaf Achad, who doesn't connect in such a column, no Tchatamitin for them. No Tchatamitin. So what's going to be the mitzvot he did? He did to others. Do you understand what I'm saying to you guys? It's crazy. You have to keep Torah, but you have to know what you live for. You have to know what you're doing. You see, we eat food. With this food, we have to carry to the central column. It's not just have to eat food because, okay, I said, because I'm not like borrow. Yeah. By the way, I want to say something. Central column is a Torah. First thing you have to know, the Torah. You, a person, have to know that by connecting yourself to the Torah, and connecting your mind, the Torah is a central column, then you could connect left and right. Then you connect left column and right column, and you could create a circuitry. You're going to create a light. You will create this way an energy of life. Only but connecting yourself to the central column. But knowing the Torah is, that's the reason when you're sitting at home, when you're saying L'Shem Yichud, you have to know that you connect, you have to know that you are such a column, and you're right now making connection between the Hashem and the Shekhinah. And then what's happening? Zivug. Which, what is Zivug? Not less than the couple getting married. The same thing. Imagine yourself. Not less than that. The way that couple has a couple getting
somebody
married.
Somebody will say, a religious person, why do I need to get married? If the zivug was there.
Say again.
So somebody will say, who's a mikubal, say, what's the point of marriage if I could do this kind of zivug without a wife?
Oh, okay. You have to know.
Bring children.
The point is not the zivug, it's the outcome. The point of you getting married is the children. That's the same outcome.
No, it's important. It's right. It's right.
You have to get married. You have to get married in life.
You have to know, Daniel. Guy, the lesson didn't finish it, so
there's,
please pay attention.
There's many kinds of zivug. There's a zivug like, yeah.
You have to know one thing. No, don't think. The zivug, which the, let's say, connection, which we're saying an intercourse in our world, and with husband and wife, because it's a connection. Mm-hmm. To make the connection spiritual, you cannot make it unless you also have a connection physical. What's physical? You have to have a wife. Woman,
very important.
She is the taking the place of a left column, by the way.
She's lefty.
She is. All the ladies, they connected in the left column. That's the reason, if you have a complaint to me, or anyone, or different complaint, saying, I cannot handle anymore, she's killing me.
Gura.
Because she's a Gura.
Yeah.
No. Not only this. And the Gura, and they, by the way, they created from the Gura. If you learn the Torah the deeply, you're going to see, the Nok, whatever you're learning with the rabbi, the Nok, the Shekhinah herself, and the Malchut, they created from the Gvurot, for the left column.
That's what there's Gvurot to step on their foot, by the
way. Now, you have to know how to make sweet that Gvurot. And when the husband know how to guide the wife's heart, basically he making sweet that judgment, that Gvurot in his wife. That, do you make a mituk of that? That the man's job. Now, divorce, Rahman al-Islam, lo al afkhar, not to nobody, is not solution. Basically, when the person getting divorced, he didn't finish complete his complete energy of three column system. He beside to finish it, you just break that. Again, it gets separated. You have to, because of that Shalom Bayit. Look at the word. Look at the word of the sages. How the sweet and sweet more than honey. They go Shalom Bayit. Look, Chidush, Shal. No, Bayit. Look about Bayit right now. We talk about the Bayit. Shalom. Did they say Shalom Sadeh, Shalom Gan? Did they say?
They're not living in a Sadeh, yeah, obviously.
But they say Shalom Bayit. Peace at the house. Why Shalom? Say Shalom Ishto with the wife. No. This is Shalom Bayit. Why? By the way. By the way. Guys, I didn't finish yet. You didn't drink a lot, don't you? Shalom Bayit. Now, the house you buy, basically that house connected to our wife. It connects to our wife. Now, when a single person buying a house, it doesn't mean his house complete. It doesn't mean. You buy, even you did for the mitzvah, still you have to make it that you get married and she gonna be in the house, and then your house getting complete. And then you Shalom Bayit.
With kids.
Then the kids come, don't worry.
Now before the house, you want to make kids.
Now, shh. Now, see now, when the person doing Shalom Bayit, let's say somebody throw his wife, or let they fight, and they separated. It's very, very important if he runs after Shalom Bayit. Basically, you want to complete that house you built. When I'm not in Beidin. I was supposed to be, but I'm not in Beidin. One of the reasons I'm not Beidin, that I didn't want to go, I will tell the truth. I want you to listen very carefully. My opinion, my personal opinion, I will be, if they will ask me, I will say I want to do the law, which the Chas v'Shalom, the divorce law, the divorce law, like a, I don't want to say that word, but like a murder law, Chas v'Shalom. Why? Why? No, you have to understand, I mean, why? Somebody is, I mean, they there's the law in the Torah that if somebody does something bad, let's say Tam Beit HaMikdash, Tam Moshe Rabbein, whatever time, and those Beit HaBeidin, somebody did something wrong. Let's say they come to conclusion, they have to, how you say that?
Excommunicate
them, or...
Harem.
Huh? Not Harem.
Kill him.
Nidui.
No,
kill. He doesn't want to say kill.
Execute.
Yes, finish him. They have to... They cannot come to conclusion, on that conclusion, unless they have to sit in the court and check, and again, and again, and again, and again, and again. They're after that doing fasting, they sit and fast. Maybe they should not make a wrong decision, because it's a matter of life and death. I mean, you're going to say, okay, he have to die. You're going to go tomorrow give answer to Hashem if you decide he should die. They have to see, and they have to find, in the end, that he really deserved that punishment, and still they're going to say, is anyone want to have any benefit of doubt to that person? If even those, nobody say anything. Shh, Abraham, you're not listening. Even those, nobody say any benefit of doubt. And he said, And he said, I want to say benefit of doubt for myself. They're supposed to say that. Never they do. They stop and they want to listen to him. Even all the 72 judges said you have to finish him. He's that's it. And if he said I have a benefit of myself, they want to listen. They will listen. If and he says something right, something, they live free. They're not gonna kill him. That's the way it's supposed to be, matter of divorces. You getting my point right now? We do that. Nobody do this. You understand the problem right now? Why? Because basically, when the person getting divorced, you are destroying Beit HaMikdash. There is sometimes no choices. That is true. We cannot say no because it's mamash have to be. That's it. You did all everything possible, but person supposed to do until last his power and energy not to bring that situation. Because in the Beit Din, when I go, whatever, I don't know which kind of, I don't want to mention, but I'm ending. If they're doing in 1, 2, 3, oh, you don't want him? Oh, you don't want her? You sure? I'm three times. 1, you sure or not? 2, 3, okay, that's it. Zaka. The baby doing? Change, you want to change. It's crazy. It's crazy. You understand? It's not for me. Instead, it's a problem. Because what you do, you basically creating. Now, because of that, when person getting married, when you have a fight at the house,
oh, this is sad.
You have to understand. You say, Lalin, okay. You know, there is a system called striking by binding.
Striking by binding. What does this mean?
Striking by binding means if there is no any argument, there is no shalom bayit. It's always like that. Down, nachon?
So it should be binding by striking.
Adachni.
Yeah, Mary, come see me.
Shh. First, Mary didn't.
What's it say? Yes.
Okay.
Got.
Okay. Eli, didn't anything, didn't he? Listen. Listen, guys. Argument. No. Argument is gonna be no matter what. It cannot be always. By the way, do you saw some people divorce? Let's say husband and wife never fight. Never fight. Let's say an American I heard in American society I heard like that. Let's say husband and wife they never fight. Suddenly, she or he get up one day. Okay, I'm leaving. Okay. He get up. One day they get up and say, I'm leaving. Ah, Makara, Chibaloza. I'm not thinking for you for me. Bye. I did fight with you. We're not that. What's going on? So it's not true by saying it doesn't mean, Eli, it doesn't mean you have to look for fight. But it's gonna be. Your job, solution. Find out. Not to give up. Find a solution. When you find the solution, you partner of Hashem for third temple. When you're not finding a solution, you're weak. You still have to work on yourself to get to the third temple solution.
Third temple solution, I like that.
She's gonna how it's connected everything.
And people who don't want to fix anything, would you call her really Jewish?
Nothing.
They just don't want to. They just want to do. They keep Shabbat, meet something, but whatever. When they're stubborn about something, would you say that's a true meaning of being a Jewish person? I wish I could.
No, it's in Chinese. No, why? It's in English. It's pure English.
You know, all my personal lessons are in the Yiddish.
The thing is, he's trying to say if the person He keeps everything, but you don't want to try, go further. I mean, you want to always in one level, always
comfortable zone.
Yeah. This is not good. This is not considered you are trying or doing, or you want to succeed, or you want to come to the level, specific receive some level. You have to work on yourself. You cannot stay always in the same place.
That's not the Jewish way.
It's the Jewish person is always going up and go. You go down, you go up. You go down, you go up. You go down, you go up. You never give up. You continuously, if you fail, even you fail, you're going to say, I'm going to get up on my level. No, you have to work on this, not only same level, even go after you fail. After you fail, you get up and you want to go highest level even. Even highest level. That's the Jewish person. That's the Jewish person. So our life is like that. So because of that, guys, when we're talking about Shalom Bayit, we talk about marriage. Look at marriage, you know, person going, to get married. I don't want to marry, Makara, all of them crazy.
Yeah,
I don't want, they're not normal, they think to me. I'm tired, I can't, it's not right. It's not right. It's not right, because you have to say like this. Are you want to be a partner of Beit HaMikdash Shlishi? Are you want to have a Chatamitim resurrection? So you have to work on it. You have to work on it. You have to work on it. You have to try all your best for that, to succeed and to get it. Not to say, I don't want to do anything, it's come to me, come. If not, forget about it. Not working out. We have to work on ourselves. And everything I want to do, I want to receive. Because of that, guys, to have a house, even in Israel, anyone who buy Israel, you have to say same thing, same words. I want to do this for Avodat Hashem. Not just because I'm an Israel, or like a Jewish, or like the Israeli people saying, why are you not keeping Torah Mitzvah, but I'm living in Israel. What do you mean in Israel? If you live in Israel, so for me to do all the bad stuff, and opposite. When you are in Israel, you have more responsibility than others, those Jews living outside Israel. You have it in your mind, but you didn't say it. It's already something, but not complete. No, it's not complete. It's already something. No, you have to say it. Even if you didn't say, you would say after.
Я вам скажу, когда вы идете to the restroom, вы же не говорите, я иду, просто идете, делаете.
No, you have to say it. No, basically, you have to say it. Make a calculation, how many?
When you come out of the restroom, you're saying
it. I see a sign, you say no?
Okay, guys, other details we're going to say next time. I see people are getting tired. So, I'm personally who left, we're going to give the blessing also to those who God's blessed already. But whoever's still here, I'm blessing all of you, B'ezrat Hashem, Barach. You sit down, you're just in your places. I'm blessing all of you, really, that the Misha Barach, and it's like this better. Misha Barach, Avotenu, Hakdushim. Avraham, Isaac, and Yaakov. Hu yivarech kol hakal hakadosh hazeh bli yotzeh megdal ktanim ugdolim. Malkat ha'alma, hu yivarech etchon v'yiten lechem bracha v'aslacha. Refuah shlema, panasa tova. Shalom bayit. You should find your soulmate b'ezrat Hashem. I should hear that you have a completeness in your life b'ezrat Hashem. You should have your soulmate and get married and build a house, Hashem Shamayim.
Lots of detail.
And all your things should be successful. Whoever married, I wish all your kids should go to the right place, to the good place, a good chatanim, a good kalot. And you should have a good kids. You should have a good grandkids. And Rabbi Shalom saying, Parnasa. And you should have a lot of parnasa b'ezrat Hashem. Sheva shel parnasa, parnasa tova, parnasa altar, parnasa l'aslacha gdola, parnasa. You should make a lot of tzedakah. You should be very rich and successful b'ezrat Hashem. And rufa shlema.
Amen.
Alata Rufa Shlema, guys. Briyud is very important.
A lot of success.
Rufa Shlema. And you should have a lot of zuchut and merit to keep Shabbat Kilchata, very important.
Amen.
And a lot of Shalom Bayit. And you should be very happy in your life.
Amen.
And you should see all of you Geulah Shlema.
Amen.
And you should be all of you deserve Chatamitim.
Amen.
And you should be all of you Mashach Tidkeinu.
Amen.
Yishuot Gdolot, Yisin Niflaot.
Amen.
Call them the hands on them, huh?
Happy birthday, Rabbi.
Thank you.
Happy birthday.